Did you know there was a knight from the Knights Templar who switched sides and led Salah ad-Din's army to retake Jerusalem? You see, in 1095, Pope Urban II called for the Christian armies of Europe to launch a holy war against the Muslims in Jerusalem in what ended up being called the First Crusade. The Crusaders made their way from Europe to Jerusalem, burning down villages and massacring entire populations along the way. And eventually, after 4 years of violence, the Crusaders arrived in Jerusalem. And after a siege that lasted weeks, they managed to take the city. 70,000 Muslim and Jewish men, women, and children were put to the sword. The population of Jerusalem was annihilated. And it was during that First Crusade that a military order known as the Knights Templar was formed. They made Jerusalem their headquarters and had the goal of keeping Jerusalem a Christian land at all costs. They were known as an elite force of highly skilled, highly organized knights. And over time, their membership grew, and soon enough, the Knights Templar became one of the most powerful and influential organizations in the world. And they remained like this for some 70 years, leading the Crusaders in battle. But that was until a man came along, someone who sowed deep fear in their hearts and constantly managed to outsmart them at every twist and turn. One of the greatest generals in the history of Islam, Salah ad-Din al-Ayyubi. In 1163, he was a commander in the Muslim army in Syria. And when the Crusaders began attacking Egypt, Salah ad-Din led his army there, crushing the Crusaders and bringing Egypt under his rule. Soon after, the ruler of Syria passed away, and Salah ad-Din took advantage of the situation and brought all of the Muslim forces between Syria and Egypt together into one army. The stage was set. The Crusaders had occupied Jerusalem for the last 90 years. They killed and massacred the Muslims and the Jews and had done so much worse than even that. And now the Muslims had united under one single banner. Every soldier knew what was coming next. And then something completely unexpected happened. In one of the most surprising and bizarre twists to the story, one of the Knights Templar switched sides. His name was Robert of St. Albans. He was a mysterious man who had joined the Knights Templars many years before and had trained to fight against the Muslim forces in the Holy Land. But as the years passed by, he developed a deep respect and admiration for the Muslims in the region. No longer did he see them as barbaric enemies that needed to be exterminated, but as a people with a rich history and culture, and a religion that made them civilized. He soon began to feel disillusioned with the Crusaders and the Knights Templar, seeing them as the true barbarians, and so he decided to join the Muslims and embrace Islam. He snuck away from the Crusaders under the cover of darkness and made his way to the Muslim armies, hoping to join them. Salah ad-Din eventually heard about him and he invited him to his camp, and after spending some time together, Salah ad-Din realized that Robert's conversion to Islam was sincere and that he was a highly skilled knight. And so he decided to make Robert a commander of one of his armies in one of the most important battles in Muslim history. In 1187, the Muslim armies began making their way to Jerusalem from the north. And along the way, they found a city that had been captured by the Crusaders, and they decided to besiege it in an effort to get it back. The Crusaders managed to send word out that Salah ad-Din had arrived, and the King of Jerusalem began marching with his army in a counterattack. But Robert had been advising Salah ad-Din on the Crusaders' strategies and tactics, and he was prepared for this. He sent a group of soldiers on horseback to attack the army and slow it down. Soon after, Salah ad-Din arrived with his full forces and completely surrounded the Crusaders. The Crusaders were now stuck in a field with no natural protection, and they were running out of water quickly. Many of the Crusaders began to flee from the battlefield, and soon enough, Salah ad-Din defeated the exhausted army, and the King of Jerusalem handed over his sword. Salah ad-Din then ordered his men to bring some ice water, and he gave a glass of it to the king and spared his life. The Crusaders had now been defeated, and Salah ad-Din marched his army to Jerusalem, and rather than entering the city and massacring its people, he made an agreement with them, and they gave him the keys to the city without any blood having been shed. Robert now walked into the city of Jerusalem along with Salah ad-Din, and soon after, he even married Salah ad-Din's niece. He was a hero amongst the Muslims, but he was still considered a traitor to the Christians. And soon after he helped liberate Jerusalem from the Crusaders, he was killed in an act of revenge just outside the city walls. May Allah count him as a shaheed. Like and follow for more Muslim facts.